Here is an introduction to the dot product. So suppose you have two vectors. Let's call the first vector vector u, and another vector, let's call it vector v. Let's put them together like this. And then there's an angle in between the two vectors right there. Now, basically, the basic idea of dot product, the notation is u dot v. And in plain English, it basically means how much is vector u helping, I'll put that in quotation marks because that's a very vague term here, how much is vector u helping vector v? Okay, so let me explain what's going on. So suppose you have a wagon and you're pulling the wagon. So the motion of the wagon is vector v. Vector v is the motion, and then you're and then vector u is a force. And so it's in let's just say the angle is right there. And so you're pulling the wagon at a certain angle in the direction of the motion. Okay, let's add a new page. So let's look at some scenarios. So here we have vector u, we have vector v. So if the two vectors are very close to each other, in other words, the angle is very, very small, then you can see that if you're pulling the wagon, almost 100% of the force you're using to pull the wagon is actually being used to pull the wagon. It's very efficient. So you have a very small angle. We have vector u is helping vector v a lot. All right, now we'll quantify this in a minute, but for now we're just getting the basic ideas. Now, the most efficient of all would be that vector u and vector v are both going exactly in the same direction. In which case, you could think of it like 100% of vector. Now, that's not quite the right way to think about it, but we'll get away with it for now. So you can think of it like 100% of vector u is helping vector v. Okay, now let's go to the other extreme. If you have vector u is perpendicular to vector v, in other words, the angle is 90 degrees, then it's not helping at all, is it? Imagine you have a wagon, you want the wagon to be pulled towards the right, and you're trying to pull it, the wagon, by pulling straight up. The wagon's not going to go anywhere. It means vector u is not helping at all. And so it turns out in this special case, and you'll see why in just a minute, the dot product u dot v actually turns out to equal zero. And this turns out to be a universal fact. Always with dot product, if you have a 90 degree angle, you will always have zero when you do dot product. All right, let's add another page here. The other situation is, what if you have an obtuse angle? You have vector u, you have vector v, and you have an angle, let's say, I don't know, how about 150 degrees? All right, so in this situation, you can say that vector u is working against vector v. And so it turns out in a situation like this, because they're pulling in opposite directions, u dot v turns out to be negative. All right, so let's think back to the different situations. What formula can we come up with that would give you 100% if the angle between is zero, a large number if the angle is small, zero if you have 90 degrees, and negative if you have 150 degrees? So it turns out that cosine will do the job. So let's go back to our original page here. So it turns out the formula for u dot v, the geometric formula anyways, is the magnitude of u. Think of it like how many newtons of force are you pulling in the direction of u, times the magnitude of V, think of it like what is the actual distance that the wagon is going, times cosine of theta. All right, now, okay, let's erase this here because I want to do some writing underneath. Okay, so now let's talk about this cosine a little bit more. So what's really going on? They call it projection. If you were to draw a 90 degree right triangle right there, think of it like how much of vector u is acting in the direction of v. And so if you draw a triangle, it's called projection, which you'll learn about in another video, but a little bit of trigonometry will tell you that the amount of force is acting in the direction of v would be this much. Here, let's use another color here. That much right there. And so what is that magnitude of that line right there? You can think of it also like the shadow of the u onto vector v if you want, but in this case we're talking about how much of the force is acting in the direction of v. And so we know that let's just do some trigonometry here for a minute. Let's just label this a, b, and c for a minute because it's the right triangle. And so we know that cosine of the angle is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse, so A over C. So you take the C, move it to the other side, and so we have cosine of theta times that C, which is the hypotenuse, which is the magnitude of vector U, is equal to the A. Okay, so now we have one more step to go. So dot product, here's where this formula is coming from now. So dot product U dot V, think of it like vector V, which is the long vector, but we're going to take just the magnitude of it. We don't care about the direction anymore. We just want the magnitude of a vector V, and then you multiply it by the amount of the vector that, of length A right there, which is how much of vector U is working in the direction of vector V right there, which we just figured out is equal to cosine theta, except instead of calling it C, I'll call it now magnitude of vector U. So I'll put that first, because that's how they always do it, times cosine of theta. So that's where the formula is coming from, right there. And that's the way to think about dot product. Once again, it's how much is vector U helping vector V, or how much is the force of vector U acting in the direction of vector V?